Sir, I support this amendment bill, sir. The Employees Compensation Amendment Bill 2016. Sir, except I have made a small amendment. So I request the Honorable Minister to consider that amendment, and that amendment is only to make it further clear the provision, sir. Sir, the clause two of the bill, whereby a new clause 17A section to be inserted in the main act, sir. Sir, here I am proposing a small amendment. After the word "inform the employee of his rights," I would like to consider, the Honorable Minister to consider to substitute the word "inform the employee of his rights" with "inform and make the employee understand his rights." Sir, as said by my friend Mr. Galla, he said that many workmen may not be available because there are few workmen who work in the persons who are not very much available with the employer at all times. So, many employees are illiterate also. So, while making this proviso, let the employee make the let the employer make the employee understand his rights. That's what I suggested, sir, through my moving an amendment, sir. Sir, the rest of the clauses, that is in section 18A and in section 30, they are increasing the amount, sir, fine amount, which I fully support. And deleting the section 30A in the Principal Act is also a welcome step, sir, because there is no need for the commissioner to withhold the compensation amount. Sir, as all of us know, sir, this Employees Compensation Act, the original act, the main act, was earlier known as the Workmen's Compensation Act, sir. Sir, this act was brought into force in the year 1923, sir. So in the pre-independent, much before, sir, more than nearly 90 years, sir. Sir, I request the Honorable Minister, the Law Commission in various reports has recommended to either repeal or amend many of the sections in the Principal Act, sir. Sir, the Honorable Minister, through this amendment bill, he tried only to amend only two or three sections in the main act, sir. Sir, earlier, various governments had made such amendments to the Principal Act, the Workmen's Compensation Act, earlier, sir. This Workmen's Compensation Act is renamed in the year 2009. Now it is called as Employees Compensation Act 1923. Sir, the Law Commission, in its report, has suggested many amendments to many sections. So I request the Honorable Minister to consider those recommendations and repeal this Principal Act and bring a comprehensive legislation in the present era, particularly after the economic reforms. The employer also changed his way of functioning also, sir. So the relations between the employer and employee in the present circumstances should be taken into consideration, and let the government come with a comprehensive legislation in the present era, as the government is specifying or mentioning, the Honorable Prime Minister is mentioning Make in India program, and we should attract many investors, not only from this country, from countries abroad, sir. So to do the ease of business, I think we should bring a new legislation with regard to the workmen, sir, that is employees, because they should also not be deprived of their compensation. Sir, at the same time, our parliamentary standing committee in its report, various reports had mentioned about the functioning of the labor courts, sir, central government interested tribunals and also the labor courts. Sir, there is no data maintained as on today, sir. How many cases are pending and how many cases are registered in various labor courts across the country? No data is there, sir. And the functioning of the labor courts is not monitored properly. And the standing committee had recommended various corrective measures, sir. Sir, till now, the government had not initiated to take any steps to follow or to accept those corrective measures as suggested by the standing committee. Sir, one important point, sir. The standing committee has also specified in its report that the Lok Adalats had disposed many cases, sir, which are pending in the labor courts. Sir, the money allocated to conduct the Lok Adalats is very meager, sir. Sir, in 2015 and 16, they have conducted around 22 Lok Adalats in the central labor courts, sir. They have disposed many cases, but unfortunately they could not conduct Lok Adalats further because of paucity of funds. So I request the Honorable Minister to allocate some amount to conduct the Lok Adalats, to dispose the cases pending before the labor courts, so that the employee, that is the workman, can get his compensation at the earliest. As mentioned by BJD MP, has mentioned that their cases are pending in various labor courts for the last 2 decades. So such pendency, we should not expect that cases will be pending so long times. So with these suggestions, sir, I would like the Honorable Minister to consider my amendment also, which is a small amendment, making the employer to make his rights understood by the employee, sir. Thank you.
Shri A. Sampath.
Thank you, Chairman.